Hey guys, so before this video starts, I'd just like to point out that yes, we know, it's been almost 2 months since we uploaded a video. Ever since lockdown has eased and all, and our parents are back to work, it's been kinda hard to find the time to be making more videos and edit them. So leave a like on this video, and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, if you want to see more of Pinoy and Arlo. Without further ado, let's see the video.
Hello! Kumusta kayo dyan? Welcome back to
Pinoy in Ireland!
It's been a while!
And today we're going to show you how we make baked sushi.
Let's go eat! Kumusta kayo dyan? Welcome to
Pinoy in Ireland!
And today, we're going to show you how we make baked sushi.
So let's get baking!
So to make sushi, we need boiled rice. And to cook boiled rice, we have here a multi-cooker. You can also use a rice cooker or a pot and juice. And cook it on the stove. So we have here 4 cups of rice, and I'm putting water so we can wash the rice. And wash it again. Knows how to wash or to cook rice, but this is for those who doesn't know how to cook yet. This is how we cook the boiled rice. So here we're just going to put water, and Filipinos, we have a trick that we use our middle finger. That line there is that where the water should be. So we need to put our finger on top of the rice. Not into the rice, but just on top of it. And just to measure if that is up to the line. Well, it is. So, now we're going to put this in our multi-cooker, or if you're using a pot, then just put it on the cooker and boil the rice. The good thing about having a multi-cooker or rice cooker, you just have to switch it on, then click rice, or if it's a rice cooker, just click whatever button is there, because that's it then. And then it will turn on and then cook by itself. When it cooks, it will be. Now, if you're using a pot, you have to wait for it until it's boiling, and then you can lower the heat until it all dries up. Now that the rice is cooked, we put enough rice on a tray, and then we will put about 3 tablespoons of vinegar. What I'm using here is apple cider, but you can also use any normal vinegar. Mix it well. Now after mixing, you just flatten it on the tray. Set this aside and we'll prepare the toppings. Now for the toppings, I have here cooked shrimp or prawns, mangoes and cucumber. And we also have a salad cream. Some uses mayonnaise, but I prefer the salad cream. Now the toppings, it depends on what you like. You can use crab meat, you can use tuna, and you can also use avocado, so whatever you want, and this is what we choose. So we'll just cut the, after peeling the mango, we just cut it into small pieces. So slice and then cut into small pieces. If you also want to use mango, make sure that the mango is not very ripe, but a little bit ripe and a little bit soft already. So I put the mango in the bowl. You can also put the prawns. So we're going to use maybe a half, just half the cucumber. So we've washed the cucumber. Now I'm going to peel it. Cut it into half. Cut it again and remove the seeds. And slice it more thinly, then cut them into small pieces again. After mixing them all together, we will put the salad cream. Put a generous amount. And this is also optional, but if you want, you can also put sweet chili sauce. and some sesame seeds. So just mix them all together. Now after mixing it, we can now put it on top of our rice. Just spread it evenly. You can also put a bit more of the sesame seed on top. Now, we'll bake this for 180 degrees for 25 minutes. Now, while waiting for our baked sushi to be finished, we'll just cut the sushi nori. Maybe cut them into four. Now here is our baked sushi. Enjoy!